Hey guys, it's Jessica from Peace Love Books, and today I'm here with a book haul. It has been quite the few weeks since I've last done my book haul. First, I want to tell you guys, if you follow me on social media, you know that I had a little accident sewing and chopped off part of my finger. It's not that big. It's mostly nail that I ended up cutting off and then like the skin under my nail. So I had to go to urgent care to get them to make the bleeding stop. It looks fine now. I had a huge wrap on it for a couple days and it was throbbing, but I was using my rotary cutter, which like looks like a pizza cutter for fabric, and slipped. So that was fun, but I am here to do my book haul. I have a few unboxings to show you. I did finally my book outlet order. I will talk about that in a second. The first thing I do want to show you is from Hello Lovely. I am a rep for them and they have a new subscription service that's actually really cheap. It's $25 including shipping and you can use a coupon code for it. So you can use Peace15. There might be a 20% off code that I don't remember that I will link down below. I'm blanking on what the code is, and I don't know if it's still good or not, but what you get is you get a large item. So this is everything that's going to be in the May box, which is still on sale for like a week. So you'll get this t-shirt. It says pizza is my favorite love triangle, and I absolutely love that. I'm obsessed with love triangles, so I love how this has a really cute design. And it also comes with a sticker with that saying. There we go. There. So that's the design that's on the t-shirt. Then we have another sticker which says romance and ice cream, which I think is really cute. And then I think the box will always come with a chapstick. So this chapstick is ice cream for ice cream. So I think they're all like themed, and this one is themed around food. And this is always from the same brand. I don't know what the actual smell is. I never opened it, so let's open it. It's like vanilla-y ice cream. It smells delicious. And then the whole point of the box though is that you get two ebooks. And so I think this is really fun. I think that's why she can keep the shipping costs down that much. So for $25, you get a large item and a couple of small items. So the small items in this box were the chapstick and the stickers, which I absolutely love stickers. I put them on like my Kindle and my computer. And then two ebooks. So the two ebooks are Tegan Hunter and Frankie Love. I hauled this book this month actually, which I'll show you. And it's A Pizza My Heart. And then this one is You Guac My World. So they're both like food related, which is what the theme of this box boxes. So I love this. I'm so excited to have these because I have Tegan Hunter, but I just purchased this book, so I haven't even read this yet. And I've been wanting to try Frankie Love for so long, and I have her ebook now. So these both come with a link on how you can download the book on the back. So I love this idea, and make sure you check out Hello Lovely. They are one of my favorite boxes ever. I love their company. I have a sweatshirt that I literally wear probably in every vlog, so that I have from them because they're amazing. But I have my book outlet order next. So the story behind this, I ordered this at the beginning of the month. It's the 30th today that I'm filming this. And it shipped on the 18th. Well, it says it shipped, but it always takes a couple days for them to like actually ship. And this went to Ohio, which is where I live, left and went to Michigan. And then it came back to Ohio. And then, like, into my city, Ohio. And then it went to Alabama. So they don't know what they were doing with this box. I literally was going to call the post office today and ask them what they were doing because it ships through USPS. And the bottom of this box is literally hanging by a thread. The entire thing is open except for one side. So no books fell out. I've seen horror stories. That's dramatic. I've seen stories of people's boxes coming like empty and open. So I know these books are not going to be like in the best of condition because they've been thrown around in a box forever. So this actually happened to my sister's book too. The first one I have is The Queens of Innisfier by Tessa Grattan. And this actually, the cover is bent. I don't know if you can see that. Can you see it? There's a line right here. Look. My sister ordered a book outlet order after me and then got it before me. But one of her covers was completely folded over and back, so I don't think they notice when they send out bent covers. None of these are scratch and dent, so that's one definitely I'll email them about. But I got that because Riley from Miley & Marie likes it. I don't know what any of these are about, so you're just gonna see what I got. The next one I got is The Traitor's Kiss by Aaron Beatty. And the bad thing about it is being in the box the whole time is that the dust jacket is now like molded to the book. So you know how like books have this crease right here of that. So my cover has that crease too. But this is a fantasy romance, I believe. And it had really good reviews. So I decided to get it. And it's super pretty. So that's why I wanted this. Then I didn't know Simone Alcalez had come out with a new book, so I got Crossing the Line. She wrote the Perfect Chemistry series, which I was obsessed with in high school. That is a YA romance with someone who's in a gang, and it's really good. So I needed to buy her new book, and I didn't know she had a new book out. Then I'm annoyed because I didn't look at the order of the series. I got The Daughter of the Siren Queen, which I didn't know was book two to Daughter of the Siren King, but I did read The Shadows Between Us by this author, and I really liked it, so I thought I would give her other books a shot. And I can't read this yet though because it's book two, but it's fine. Then I did subscribe to Fairy Loot, and one of the books that they are creating merch for the box is Rebel of the Sands by Alwyn Hamilton, and I just heard really good things about this. The cover's pretty, it's a fantasy, that's all I know. Then I got, because it was super cheap, 9 Days and Nine Nights by Katie Cotugno. This one I think is the sequel to another one though, and I'm pretty sure I have that other one. And this one, I think they travel through Europe, so yeah. Oh, look at that. This, I just like really like the design of this. I didn't realize it was that short though. That is a short YA book. Then it got a little damaged in the box, but I guess it's fine. I got Traitor of the Throne, which is the book two to Rebel of the Sands. Even though they like don't go together at all. Like who did this? I think they had the paperback version of this cover, but I didn't want two matching paperbacks. So yes, I got book two as well, which doesn't match, but it's fine. And then I got An Enchantment of Ravens by Margaret Rogerson. I really like Sorcerer of Thorns, and this one is like fae, and I'm pretty sure she like is a painter and she paints emotion into the fae's painting, and they're not supposed to feel emotion, so she gets in trouble. And that's all I know. And then the last book I got is The Queen's Rising, which I believe is hopefully the first book in this series. And it is another fantasy. So I've just been in the mood for fantasy YA books. This is the first one. The other book in the beginning is the sequel. So I've been really wanting YA fantasy, so that's why I got that. And then I got Her Every Fear by Peter Swanson. I looked up the reviews for this. It is an adult thriller, and people have said it's really good. I don't know what it's about. This says it's a Hitchcockian psychological thriller, like Rear Window and Wait Until Dark. It says a young woman caught in a vice of voyeurism, betrayal, manipulation, and murder. So we'll see if I read that when I do, because I'm a scaredy cat, so maybe I have to wait till during the day to read that book. But that was my book outlet order. It survived. This is the bottom of the box and how it came open. So I'm happy it didn't actually spill open, and I'm happy it finally made it to me. But I have a lot of other books to share with you. This is gonna be a long video, but I have been placing a lot of used book orders. I have been in the mood for a lot of historical romances, and so I've been using Better World Books, and that'll be linked down below. I don't get anything from that, so if you want to use that, go for it. Book Outlet's always linked down below. If you use my code, I get some money off, so that's all I get from that. And then Thrift Books as well, I'll link that down below. I've been using primarily Better World Books because they've been having a couple sales, so I'm just gonna go through these. I don't know what any of these are about. I'm not gonna take the time to read the synopses for all these for you because I don't want to, and I like to go into books blind. So the first one, I really also order these because of the covers. I don't even look at what they're about. But the first one is Love Remember Me by Beatrice Small. These are really old books. A lot of them come with a spine crease, and they all say good condition. You just have to check that it's not a library edition and just hope for the best. So this one I definitely got for the cover, and I always look up the Goodreads reviews. So even if I don't know what they're about, I look to see if people liked them, and people liked this one. I also got The Black Lion by Jude Devereaux. I'm waiting for Knight in Shining Armor by Jude Devereaux because that one's a time traveling romance. This one is just another one. It came as a library copy, and I'm pretty sure it didn't say it was, but I have that one. I also got Gentle Warrior by Julie Garwood. A lot of them I just buy because of the old school gorgeous covers, and you see how like reflective that like metallic pink is. There we go, that's better. You see that? Pretty. The next one I got is A Matter of Scandal by Suzanne Enoch. This is one I bought for the cover mostly, and I've heard good things about this author, so I added it to my cart. I also have heard good things about Donna Fletcher, so I got two of her books. I got Legendary Warrior and Dark Warrior. I think these might be in the same series. These don't say where these take place, but I have them because they looked good and they had good reviews. And then I also have When the Duke Returns by Eloisa James. I know I got this one because I knew what it was about. So she is married, but it says married by proxy. I don't know what that actually means. I'm assuming she was like betrothed to someone and never actually met him. So they're married and she's never met him. And she finally lures him back to London and is determined to be married to him no matter how unattractive he turns out to be. And apparently they actually really like each other and he wants an annulment. So that sounds really good. If I did, I apologize if I talked about these in my last video, but I do have Once and Always by Judith McNaught. I bought a bunch of her books because I love her books now. I read my first one by her, A Kingdom of Dreams, and I loved it. So I also got Paradise and Almost Heaven, which came paper clipped on to the cover. There's no even like crease in the spine or anything. I just think it's so old that the glue literally just like stopped working. And then Whitney My Love, which this is the old copy, and I've heard she's changed parts of it that were problematic. So if you know anything about that, let me know if I have to find a newer copy of this, but I just really love this cover, so that's why I have this. And then by Kathleen Woodowis, I got A Rose in Winter and The Flame in the Flower. I've heard one of these is a little problematic as well, so that's what you kind of get when you have like 80s, early 90s historical romances, but I'm excited to try her books out because I've heard that they are really good. Those are the historicals I bought, and I have another order of 29 Joanna Lindsay books on its way, so yay, I'm excited, but I am not allowed to buy any more historical romances, so I will go ahead and get to the other books that I bought. Then I ended up getting Unravel by Callie Reid. I love her Surviving Trace series, and I know that she had some traditionally published books, and she is self-publishing those other ones. This one, she's a psych patient? I don't know, but I don't know if there's more to it, like fantasy paranormal aspects. I don't know. I just bought it, so I have it. The next one I have is The Bear and the Nightingale. I was looking again at fantasy that I wanted to read, some more adult fantasy, and so I ordered this one. I know people absolutely love this, and it's Russian folklore, I believe, and it's the first in a trilogy. I don't want to know too much about it, so I haven't read the back. So I have that. And then I did, like I said, get two Tegan Hunter books. I got these because Tegan Hunter was supposed to be at a PolyCon. I think it was a PolyCon. It was one of the signings I was going to that got canceled. And so she, for her pre-order, they were $10 each. So she decided to go ahead and send those out to people. And so they are both signed to me. They are like cutesy rom-coms. And I read Let's Get Textual, I think, by her. And I really enjoyed it. So I'm very excited to read these. This one's a best friend's sister romance with the guy who works at the pizza shop. I don't know what this one is. So they sound really fun though, so I'm excited to read them. And they're pretty short, so I feel like I can fly through them. With The Bear and the Nightingale, I also decided to pick up City of Brass, which I don't know anything about and I don't want to know too much about. I do know that there is a good romance in here, and this is some people's favorite fantasy of all time. So book three I know is coming out soon, so I really wanted to get to this. It is very long though. Why is fantasy so long? Oh, I guess it's not too long. This is only 500 pages, so that's not too long to me. Then I did get an arc of The Silent Wife by Karen Slaughter. I need you guys' help. Let me know if I have to read this series. I didn't even know this was part of a series. And someone on Instagram told me I couldn't read this without reading the first book in the series. And I think this is book like 10. So let me know. I think it comes out like in July or something. And it has to do with a man who, it says, all he ever wanted was someone to love. He watches, he waits, he takes who will be his next silent wife. So I have not read a Karen Slaughter book yet, but I really want to read this and I'm ready. I say that, but I know she's intense. Next is a lovely follower. She on Instagram decided to send me a book when she watched my vlog and saw how down I was feeling, and she sent me Credence by Penelope Douglas. So this is from Sammy from Fragrant Pages. I didn't remember what her Instagram name was, but I am so excited to have this, and I did give it 4 stars, but it's been on my wish list for a while ever since it came out because I literally need to own every Penelope Douglas book ever. And she did say she was reading this because she was very intrigued, and she's like 7% in, It is quite the wild ride, but look how chunky that is. I did not realize how long this book was. Maybe I did while I was reading it, but I forgot because I read it as an ebook, so I wasn't holding this, but thank you to Sammy. I'm very, very excited to have this. Then I didn't realize this was on Book Outlet, but my sister ended up adding it to her order, and that is The Last Hope by Kristen Becker Ritchie. This is book two to The Raging Ones, which I haven't read yet, but I really want to read it, and I love Kristen Becker's adult romance series, new adult romance series, so I wanted to read this. It's sci-fi, I think. I don't know. And then I saw Brie from In Love and Other Words. She posted about this and then she tagged me in her next post. But I saw the first one and I was like, oh my god, what is that book? And then her next post, she tagged me asking me if I heard of it. And it is Angels of Darkness, and it is a short story collection of Nalini Singh, Alana Andrews, Mel Jean Brooke, and Sharon Shin. Sharon Shin's the only one I haven't heard of, but they're angel romances. And I've been obsessed lately, so I had to buy my own copy. I got it from Better World Books, and it's literally not even a crease spine. It looks brand new, so I'm very excited about that. Then I decided to order myself a copy of Feast of Sparks by Sierra Simone. I think this was like $13, and it's originally like $17, so I decided to jump on that sale. And this one is the second one to Lust in Thorns, which is a polyamorous, very atmospheric, dark romance. And I have not heard the best of things about book two, but book three comes out any day now, so I wanted to get this so that I can jump right into book three and like not be disappointed, maybe? Does that mentality make sense? I don't know. Then I was sent a copy of The Iron King by Julie Kagawa. Kagawa, I think you say that name. This is the 10-year like anniversary edition. It was redone, which I love this new cover so much better than the old covers. The old covers were very dated. They were very 2010s. This one is very now. These are YA Fae books. I don't know anything else really about them. I do think that the rest of the series is possibly getting a cover redesign. I don't know, but it's very pretty and I'm excited to finally read this 10 years later than when it was released. Then I got myself a copy of You Deserve Each Other by Sarah Hogle. This one was on my May TBR, hate to love romance. They're engaged. Something happens that breaks them up, but they don't want to be the one to call off the wedding because the person who calls it off has to pay all the bills. So they end up falling in love again. Hate to love, very excited. I've heard mixed things, but I've heard a lot of people love it, so I hope that I love it as well. I also got myself a copy of Little Fires Everywhere by Celeste Ng for the Little Fires read-along that I'm doing with Allie from Mrs. Dunn Reads and a couple other booktubers I'm hosting on Instagram. So I can't wait to read this. It is the Asian Readathon 2 in May, so I need to read it. And it's really cute and tiny, even though it's over 300 pages. I'm excited to read this. Then I also decided to get War by Laura Thalassa. This one was on sale as well on Amazon, so I got this with A Lesson in Thorns, Feast of Sparks, whatever that second book was. I got it with the second book. And this one is a post-apocalyptic Four Horsemen, kind of. It's kind of like during the apocalypse, I guess. Well, kind of post, they're trying to survive after the apocalypse happens. First pestilence came, now war is here, and they all fall in love with a woman. I got halfway through and never finished, but it's a long book, so it's 500 pages. I got 250 pages in. I just have to finish. Then the amazing Catherine Cowell sent me a package and it's super adorable. She sent me a book sleeve and it has my name on it and it looks so cute next to this book. This is Reckless Memories and it sounds so good and I really actually want to read it. I had emailed her saying I don't know if I'll be able to get to it because I have a lot of reading plans and it sounds really good. So I guess they like fell in love and then he broke her heart and he's back, or it's some kind of second chance angsty romance, and the covers look so gorgeous and it did come with a little postcard and a bookmark. Her aesthetic of all of her books is literally amazing and I believe this is the beginning of a new series, so I'm excited about this and I am very thankful to the author for sending me a copy of that. Then I was sent a copy of Wrong Turn by Samantha Chase. This is a signed copy for me, which is very exciting, from the author. This one, it sounds funny. It's, she hates her best friend's fiance, and her best friend's fiance's best friend hates her. So I think like their best friends are getting married. And I don't know if it's a road trip romance, but it sounds like it's a rom-com, so I'm excited to have this and I can't wait to give it a shot. Then I did an unboxing of the Dangerous Book Club box that I got in my Reading Rush vlog, and that came with two books. It came with the Australia Anthology, which is giant. I normally don't buy anthologies, but this one, the proceeds went to the Australian wildfires, and this one has a lot of amazing authors. Penny Reed, Emma Scott, Sierra Simone, Kennedy Ryan, Gianna Darling, all those kind of people, and it's a lot. But I'll try to read it. And then it also came with Half-Truths by Claire Contreras, which I actually own a copy of already. I found this at Half Price Books and bought it, and I think this is like a dark romance. It says it's a romantic suspense novel. Oh, it's like secret societies too. So I'll probably do a giveaway of this at some point. Then I did buy myself a copy of The Queen and the Cure by Amy Harmon. I've heard that these are really amazing fantasy romances. And there's a king, and there's dynamics like that. I can't figure out what this is about because this is book two. So I know it's fantasy, and I'm excited to own those two now. And then the last book I have out sent by the publisher is Time of Our Lives by Emily Wibberly and Austin Siegman Broke. I didn't have to look at the cover this time. This one is their new release, and it is about a girl and a guy who are seniors in high school, and they meet touring colleges. They're at very different parts of their lives, where like one of them wants to get away to go to college, one of them wants to stay super close to go to college, and they fall in love. So it sounds very cute, and I'm excited to read this one. And that's my book haul. I'm sorry that's long. I'm sorry I keep on buying books and wanting to share them with you. I know I need to stop, but I get them super cheap. I get them from used bookstores. Well, I got a couple Amazon orders because I want to buy books because I can't get them anywhere else. And so I have a problem, but that's what I got. Let me know down below if you're excited about anything that I got and what you've gotten recently. I would love to hear. As always, thank you so much for watching and have a good day.